Now that you've learned how to initialize an empty Git repository, let's talk about how to add changes to a repository. In my recipes directory, I have the three files cakerecipe.txt, frostingrecipe.txt, and chilirecipe.txt on my hard drive, which is called my working directory. I also have an empty Git repository that I just created. Now I'd like to add a commit to this repository. Now you might think I could just run git commit to create a snapshot of the current state of my files. However, Git allows you a bit more control than this. Recall that it's a good idea to keep commits small with one commit per logical change. Git makes it easier for you to do this by allowing you to specify exactly what changes should be committed. To accomplish this, Git uses an intermediate area called the staging area. You can add files one at a time to the staging area. For example, first I might add the cake recipe, and then the frosting recipe. Then, when I'm ready to commit, Git bundles the entire contents of the staging area into a single commit and adds that to the repository. Let's see how this works on the command line. To remember what I've added so far, I'll use git status, and I see that I still need to make my initial commit, and my three files are still untracked. Now the command to add files to the staging area is called git add. First I'll add the file cakerecipe.txt, and then I'll add the file frostingrecipe.txt, since I think it makes sense to put the cake and the frosting recipes in the same commit. Now I'll run git status again, and I can see that these files show up as new files under changes to be committed. This is Git's way of saying that they have been added to the staging area, since if I created a commit now, these files would be included. Now go ahead and use git add to add whatever files from your reflections repository you would like to put in your first commit. Which file or files will you add? Will you add both files in one commit, or will you use separate commits for each file? And why? Write your answer in this box. After your staging area contains the changes you want in your first commit, run git status and paste the output in this box.